The following is rated TV-MALSV. It contains strong language, violence, and nudity. It is intended only for mature audiences. Viewer discretion advised.
It rests on 13 acres of earth, over the very center of hell. Sights and sounds far beyond anything you've tested. To avoid fainting, keep repeating.
It's only a movie. Only a movie.
Take as only much as you can.
Only a movie.
This is my creation. We can truly experience the universe. My job is to surprise everyone with something new. Thinking of new dreams.
George Lucas.
Swing!
Oh, something new.
Genjitsu no katachi ni shite kita.
The winner is Woody Allen.
In this universe, new dreams and new friends.
Kono uchuu wa atarashii yume to nakama de ippai da.
Sonic. Always new dreams, wonderful friends, something new.
This is what happens when your boyfriend gives you a bracelet and dumps you to be with your best friend. Have fun with her, Ryan.
Now I know y'all be loving this right here.
But all that is about to change. With an unexpected trip to a place called Cleveland. A romance with a girl named Beverly.
He's my boyfriend!
And an adventure beyond the imagination of the average duck.
The duck's a lunatic!
George Lucas presents Howard the Duck, a Willard Hike film, a Gloria Katz production. Rated PG. Now at select theaters, check newspapers.
Oh yeah, it's good stuff, man.
You could dance,
The dancing?
Dancing?
No, something new.
You can take to this job like a duck to water.
George Lucas for Star Wars.
Swing!
Excuse me.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, hi, Mrs. Harris. I didn't see you come in. I'm
haven't seen you in a week or so. Have you been out of town or something?
Oh, no. Our VCR was just in for repairs again. It was awful. Can you imagine trying to make conversation with Mr. Harris?
Our trailer tape must have jammed.
Oh, no. Our VCR was just in for repairs again.
It's fucking broken! I fucking hate this thing.
It was awful. Can you imagine trying to make conversation with Mr. Harris? Well, anyway, it's back now.
Good. You know, we have a lot of different movies you might not have seen before. Can I help you find anything in particular?
Oh, thanks. I'll just look around. I'm sure I'll find
something new.
So, I guess I'm digitizing fucking surf ninjas and shit. Look at this fucking thing. Goddamn thing's probably older than I am. Look at how many fucking switches and buttons and shit it has. God damn it.
They were ordinary California kids who got the surprise of their life when someone gave them the power of the ninja.
Sorry.
Now they have to be all that they can be.
Because
they're America's newest secret weapon.
Why do you keep calling us that?
Surf ninjas.
There's dynamite here.
We'll throw it at them.
It's a tough job, but somebody's got to do it.
I got one.
Rated PG. Starts Friday at a theater near you.
I am quite certain that there's been a big mistake.
And now, a sneak preview of upcoming video cassette releases.
Cyborg Cop 2. Nur einer kann die unberechenbaren Killermaschinen stoppen.
Ryan, verschwinde von hier! Denn du machst nur Ärger.
Sie haben recht, Ärger liegt mir im Blut.
Jack Ryan dachte nicht einmal in seinen schlimmsten Albträumen daran, jemals wieder einen tödlichen Kampf mit den teuflischen Cyborgs zu führen.
Rühr dich nicht von der Stelle, Raven.
Dem großartigen Erfolg von Cyborg Cop jetzt die actiongeladene Fortsetzung des Science-Fiction-Thrillers. Eine Zeitbombe explodiert.
Wir sehen uns in der Hölle, Jack Ryan!
Natürlich wieder mit Superstar David Bradley. Diese neue Cyborg-Generation ist gewaltiger, brutaler und raffinierter als die Computer, von denen sie programmiert wurden. Cyborg Cop 2.
Something new.
Never mind. Never mind. Never mind. Yeah. Never mind.
The 29th Annual American Music Awards.
And the winner is...
Isso é bacana.
Shit.
Puta merda.
This is a huge surprise.
Isso é uma grande surpresa.
To be one of the world's most hated rock bands.
Ser uma das bandas mais detestadas,
right,
umas bandas mais detestadas do mundo, recebeu um prêmio agora.
And we got a madman.
E tem um louco.
The winner is
Brad Durst.
In this universe, new dreams and new friends.
この宇宙は新しい夢と仲間でいっぱいだ。
new dreams, wonderful friends.
Panasonic. いつも新しい夢。素晴らしい仲間。
And now with something new.
Centimeters on the figure of Osiris, Doctor.
18. Very good. And the representation of Nefertiti, Professor?
12 centimeters.
Excellent. And the last measurement?
Let's see. Hathor is 11.
What is that?
Earthquake!
Careful, Professor.
This is incredible.
What have you found, my friend?
Hank Van Har. Yes. Hank Harris.
Are you all right?
Three of you on each side. Come on, give me a hand. Okay. Carefully.
Could you all sort of move around to the other side of the coffin?
Linda, this is fairly heavy. Must we pose right now?
Rossmore wants a bunch of publicity stills for their press conference tomorrow. Tomorrow?
Yeah. It seems we have no choice.
Professor, could you move over here and smile at the mummy?
Seals.
Which means the fella inside hasn't seen the light of day in approximately 3,000 years. Okay, fellas, one on each side. Lift it carefully. Okay, easy. Just put it right over there. Perfect condition. Can anyone translate the name?
Ankh Ven Haris, a male cognomen, literally a noble traveler.
Meaning?
I guess he was a visiting dignitary.
Why would they bury a foreigner in the tomb of King Tut?
That's a good question, Michael. Maybe we'll find the answer in the scroll of dedication. All right, let's go for the inner lid now, carefully.
Watch it, you idiot!
Sorry, sir.
Sorry's not gonna help when you break some of the machinery. Ready for the x-ray, sir.
All right. Carefully.
Anyone tell me why the wrappings are so deteriorated?
Hasty burial. Minimum preparation.
Yeah, I'd say that's likely.
What is that green stuff? Mold?
Not really sure. Michael, why don't you collect some samples?
Okay, Doc.
Professor, why would he have been given a hasty burial?
Well, until we remove the wrappings and examine the body, we're not going to know for sure. But my guess is Ankh Ven Haris died from some kind of disease. Such as plague or smallpox, or whatever it was that disfigured and killed his attendants. Susie, bring me an airtight container. I want to seal this up until we can give it a proper cleaning. Michael?
Just about done, Doc.
I think we're ready for the x-rays. Thank you for your help. And I'll see you all later.
Thanks,
sir.
Bye.
So long, Parker.
No, I'd like Mr. Parker to stay. After all, he is the chief engineer.
Ready? Aim. Fire. Ready? Aim. Fire. Ready? Aim. Fire. What are you doing, you moron?
Doug, look at that.
My God, Sharp!
One of those damn kids must have knocked it off the setting.
You've been x-raying this mummy with 10 times the normal dose.
Okay, so we'll start again.
Let's not. He's had enough radiation for one night. Just deliver those plates to my office.
Dose. Don't worry, big fella. This isn't gonna hurt a bit. A perfect match. Thank you.
x-rays?
Just put them over there. I want to finish cleaning this grill.
I don't know, Ken. Some kind of dormant mold.
Great. I'll help Susie run it over.
And thanks, Ken. Ken Milrose in pathology can start analyzing it right away. Can you bring it over to him? You mind?
Of course not. Maybe he'll show me his new electron microscope.
Well, I mean, what have I got that can compete with that? Oh, honey, before you go, what do you think of this? I found it rolled up in the scroll.
Magic symbols? Astrological diagram?
Look at the material. I've never seen anything like it. It's not papyrus. It's not leather, cloth.
Well, maybe you found the first civilization to use polyester.
What a dismal thought.
Don't work too late, Doc. Sorry, did I startle you?
Oh, Susie, what time is it?
Gonna look worse than Ankh van Haris at the press conference.
Susie, look at this. Notice the cranial structure. The line of the spinal column.
Maybe there's something wrong with the x-ray machine.
No, no. Here, coffin came out perfectly. And look at this. Usually the internal organs are removed and prepared separately, but here they're all intact. This mummy hasn't been prepared in the standard manner.
What's this?
Probably a hidden compartment for personal jewelry. That's not unheard of.
We'll find out. This stuff.
Don't touch it. Get Ken Melrose and tell him something has happened to the mold. Hurry, go on.
Worthless.
Worthless? What do you mean, worthless?
I mean they're not precious.
They're 3,000 years old. They're ancient, man.
Well, who told you that? Some hustler in a swap meet?
Forget it. Clown.
It is the same fungus.
But it's definitely no longer dormant.
And you have no idea what it is.
Nope. And until we find out, don't let anyone near it.
It's not going to be easy. Rossmore scheduled a press conference for today. He wants to introduce Ankh van Haris to the public.
Okay, Doug. I'll call Rossmore and tell him he simply must cancel.
Thanks, Ken. Appreciate that.
Evening news. Is this a stiff?
Michael, see if you can find something to rope the coffin off with, please.
Okay, Doug.
Be sure everyone stays clear of the coffin, including you.
Doug?
He wants to talk to you.
No, we don't know for sure that it's dangerous.
Look, I'll get back to work on this, and if I learn anything, I'll call you.
Thanks, Ken. Thanks.
Get him to the campus hospital, to the emergency room. Call Melrose as soon as you get there. And don't touch his hand! Please, just have a seat, please.
McCadden, what is the meaning of all this commotion?
One of my students was just burned by this fungus.
Fungus?
Come on, you know damn well what I'm talking about. Melrose and I tried to warn you about this.
And you know, I really resent being blamed for the clumsiness of one of your students. Now, if you're unwilling to accept the responsibility for this project, perhaps we ought to find someone who will. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. My name is Wendell J. Rossmore. Today we are formally announcing the permanent acquisition of a major artifact from the tomb and the treasure of Tutankhamun.
Cover the mummy, you're going to notice that the wrappings are very deteriorated and covered with a green substance. This may make him seem rather unattractive, but please remember, he's been in there for 3,000 years.
Gentlemen, you may remove the inner lid.
Hey, look, I wasn't the only one in the lab that night.
Don't you belong to a fraternity, Sharp?
Yes. So what?
Hey, Pete, I was a frat man. I know what it's like. Slow night, nothing to do. Have a couple of beers.
Steal a mummy?
That's a great theory, Captain. Try to prove it.
Why, you little...
Hey, listen. Why don't you ask Parker where he was that night? I saw him there.
Dr. Rossmore, Jack Parker is not a suspect.
The most important thing is we've got to find the mummy. We've got to counteract the bad press generated by that disaster this morning. Sharp.
Yes, sir.
I want you to spread the word through the fraternity houses. I am offering a 24-hour amnesty to get the mummy back. Now, if he is not returned, I am going to close every frat house and search every room on this campus.
Yes, sir.
All right. Sharp. And Parker, you may go.
Captain, I think the city police should be brought in on this.
Absolutely not. Now, come on, this is an internal affair.
We don't need them.
You're overreacting, Doug.
That mummy could be dangerous. There is something on the wrappings. Something very strange. There's already a boy in the hospital. Anybody else who touches that mummy could end up the same way.
If that's so, whoever has taken the mummy is going to end up in the hospital sooner or later.
And then I'll nab him.
And nobody has to know about it. Not the police. Not the press.
Fine. I better find that mummy before somebody else gets hurt.
Mm-hmm.
What's going on back here?
Captain Willoughby, I want you to search the campus. Turn it upside down if necessary, but find that mummy.
Yes, sir. You got it.
Here's why I'm so concerned. The structure is just crazy. The nucleus is unstable. The chromosomal pattern is mystifying. And the cells are multiplying at a rate so fast, I can hardly measure it. Yes. We'll be right there.
Yes, whatever it is, it's highly dermatropic.
It breaks down tissues faster than anything we've ever encountered.
And it doubles its mass reproductively every 65 minutes, provided it has enough food.
Food?
Well, any organic tissue.
In this case, human flesh.
Hi, Doc. I'm sorry I screwed up your show.
It's okay. You were upstaged by the disappearing act anyway.
When you find that guy, I want to be the first one that knows.
You got it. Mind if I take a look at that hand?
Sure, Doc.
Take care of yourself, Michael.
Dr. Fair, you're needed in emergency ward number 4. Please answer extension number 75.
What's the prognosis?
Well, there's no skeletal damage yet, but the nerves, tendons, musculature, circulatory vessels are virtually destroyed. Excuse me, Dr. Hayward, Mrs. Goldstein is here. Fine. I'll be right there. Excuse me, gentlemen, but I will stay in touch.
Wait a minute, Doctor. Truthfully, what can you do for him?
Amputate before it goes any further.
Doing?
Sherry, honey, I came over to see you.
Then what were you staring at her for, both?
Oh, I don't know. Sherry,
I don't believe you.
Listen, Sherry, will you listen for a minute? Come on, baby, don't be mad. I brought you a present.
What?
Give me a kiss first.
No way.
No kiss, no present.
Okay, where's my present? Wow. Where'd you get this?
I found it in an old box.
Dr. Serrano? Hey, this is Captain Willoughby. Yeah. Look, I'm in the electrical supply room. The President Rossmore told me to call you if I saw anything suspicious.
This is Linda Flores taking your request tonight, so give me a call at 662-8200. And now, to Brian from Sheila and to Christy from all the guys at Delta Psi.
So this is
where you hide out when you're not taking my picture, huh?
Cheapest rent on campus, right next to the reactor.
Hi, I'm Jamie Reynolds.
And so am I. No, I'm Dick Travland, and this is tonight's edition of Two on One.
Today, here at the California Institute of the Sciences, they held a press conference to show off their new mummy. But when they opened the coffin, guess what?
It wasn't a mummy. It was a daddy.
Oh, my God.
No, it wasn't anything. The coffin was empty.
Empty?
As a tomb.
I wonder how much they paid for that thing.
Whatever it was too much.
Jamie, I think the Institute is in grave trouble.
Oh, Dick.
Sorry. At any rate, it all started this morning when Wendell J. Rossmore of the Institute called a press conference to show the world their find.
It's worth over $100. I could let you have it for, say, 50.
Hey, where am I going to get 50 bucks?
Hey, come on, Greg. I know you got paid today. Just imagine what Ellen's going to think when you walk in with a present like that.
Name your restaurant, baby. Excuse me. Sherry, I'll be right back.
Brother Sharp! Imagine meeting you here.
Yeah, especially in this outrageously expensive restaurant with 9 different kinds of forks.
How do you suppose he can afford a place like this, Brother Robinson?
Hey, look, it's hard to figure, Brother Vogel, especially since he owes us $25 a piece.
Hey, look, come on. I need that. I just ordered the food.
It's okay. We'll pay for it.
We'll eat it, too. Look, I'm here with Sherry.
Okay. We'll eat her food, too. And listen, I know we can share the food, but listen, we have to flip for the lady. Tails seems appropriate.
Hey, how would you guys like to double your money? Give that to a girl, she'll never forget you.
Okay, it's a deal.
Hey, baby.
Oh. Shh, don't wake the baby. I promised Miss McGinnis I'd be really quiet. Come on.
Are they gonna come home?
Not until midnight.
This is Linda Flores on KCIS.
And now, a special message for those naughty boys and girls who took the Institute's mummy. Here's my in-studio guest, our own Professor Douglas McCadden.
Thank you very much, Linda. To whom it may concern, the fungus on the mummy's wrappings is extremely dangerous.
If you have come into contact with it, please seek medical attention at once. If you discover the mummy, do not touch it.
Call the police or the Institute or even this radio station.
Thank you.
promise she'll be the first reporter on the scene.
Thought I lost it there for a minute. Guess it must have fallen out of my pocket into the baby's crib. He sure liked it. I hope you do, too.
Greg, it's beautiful.
That wasn't glowing like that when I bought it.
Oh, it's so warm.
Can't you let the kid cry?
He wants his doll. I'll be right back.
Can you treat her?
Oh, Lieutenant Plummer. I believe you know our pathologist, Ken Melrose.
Of course, Lieutenant.
And this is Professor Douglas McCadden of the Institute.
Professor?
I've brought Lieutenant Plummer up to date on everything.
Doctor, what about Ellen?
Well, I'm consulting by phone with Dr. Cunningham of the Atlanta Center for Control of Disease.
Oh? You expecting an epidemic?
No, but if anyone knows anything about unusual disorders, it's Atlanta.
We've sent them samples.
They have all our data now, you see.
And what have they come up with?
So far, nothing.
I understand there was a witness to this accident involving the girl.
Yeah, her boyfriend, Greg Hauser. He's here in the hospital now.
Okay, Hauser. Describe the attacker. Was he black? White?
Come on, let's hear it now. Don't sit there. Talk!
Well, that's enough, Willoughby. I'll take it from here.
Hey, Plummer, this kid saw the guy who did it. I'm trying to get a description, but he won't cooperate.
That'll be all, Captain Willoughby.
Greg, this is Lieutenant Plummer from the police department. He wants to ask you a few questions, that's all.
Greg, was it? Okay, Greg. Now just tell me what you saw. Whose face, Greg? Whose face was it?
Mommy.
Look, he's still in shock. I think I'd better take him under observation for a few hours. Greg, come with me.
Michael Goldstein.
They had to amputate. But I think they got it all.
Ken. How's Ellen this morning?
Dr. Hayworth wants to try a surgical laser to burn the fungus off, just as soon as they make sure there aren't any broken bones. I took a look at these x-rays you sent me.
What'd you think?
You were right. Skeletal structure is abnormal. An extended clavicle, oversized sternum, displaced mastoid process.
Doug? Hi, Ken.
Hi, Susan.
Ken, I want you to listen to this. I think I'm onto something. This scroll. It basically tells a story of King Tutankhamun's soldiers discovering a stranger in the desert. All right. Because of his unusual appearance, the Egyptians assumed him to be a god, sent to advise their own god king. So, King Tut goes forth to greet this deity, whom he calls Ankh-Venharis. Now, listen to this. All-knowing Tutankhamun reached out to touch the weary traveler and was sorely burned and afflicted with a disease that consumed his flesh.
Likewise were all servants who laid soothing hands on the boy king. All died, save only the strange traveler himself, who lay near death and without strength, but who would not pass into the afterworld.
So they simply sealed him alive in a corner of Tut's tomb, along with all the afflicted servants.
Tell me something. Are you suggesting that our fungus is the same disease that killed Tut and his servants, and it's been dormant for 3,000 years, and now it's not?
Suppose it were true. Okay, just suppose. What would we have to do?
We'd have to figure out how it was stimulated out of dormancy. Then we might know how to stop it.
Well,
but Doug, it's an unbelievable concept.
What else have we got?
Damn it! Have you seen this? We look ridiculous. We were seen on every channel.
Mm-hmm. And look at this. Where is my mummy? A fraternity party Saturday night. Please wear costumes. That's all we need.
Oh.
Get a hold of her. Tell her not to x-ray Ellen Winter. Do not x-ray Ellen Winter.
What is it? Are you still going out with Professor McCadden?
I don't think that's any of your business, Stanley. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got a very busy schedule.
Well, look, I'm sorry. This conversation hasn't gone as I'd hoped it would. Here, take this.
I can't take this.
Take this. Think of me, and maybe I'll see you sometime.
Stanley!
Out of here. What was that?
nothing but a damn door. Keep looking. Somebody must have broke in.
It's the fungus.
The mummy walked.
Stop it! Peter!
Mummy needs love. Mummy been in box too long.
Get off of me!
Hey, look, man, I was only kidding.
Hi, Jack. How do I look?
Come on.
As Cleopatra would say, see you later, guys.
Did he hurt you?
No, I'm all right. Thanks for being there.
Conehead.
Peter, grow up. Just grow up. I swear you are such a dork sometimes. Gross.
Hey, Peter, you want maybe I should make your black mummy?
I'm Cleopatra.
Lost in King Tut's tomb. 9 months later, she was a mummy.
Hey, Peter, I thought you were gonna wear a costume.
Love your outfit, Bill.
Thanks. Love your necklace. It's so unique.
You still get a truck one of those things? Excuse us, pal.
Enough of this crap. Now listen, you pervert. You don't disappear, I'm gonna kick your bandage butt.
What is that?
Some chicken crap, right? Sarah, I got a present for you.
No. think she's outside.
Sarah! Sarah! Sarah, is that you? No! She's not Sarah! And I sure as hell ain't. Just want to get lost. Sarah!
Bill! Jeff!
Ready, Sarah?
Hey, Sarah, what is going on?
Sorry, buddy, this is only a two-seater.
Hey, Sarah, what happened? Damn! That's it. I'm through with women. I'm gonna be a priest. Well, hello.
Hi.
How are
you,
ladies?
I like your dress.
I like you. I'll be right back.
Where are you going?
Be right back. All right.
Check this out.
Can I come along?
No, I'll be right back. Really, I just want to see if there was some sort of power drain.
Be careful.
Lock the door and keep it locked.
On the wall right there, so whoever stole the mummy must have stashed him in here. Oh, look who's here. Come to change a light bulb, Parker?
No, actually, I came to blow up the reactor. Hey, do you need any help? Hey!
Hey, Bill?
He's dead.
Right over.
Ah, Professor. Thought you might be interested in this.
What happened?
We found this.
It's definitely from the mummy's wrappings.
Looks like somebody's playing a very sick game.
Please stay away from the green stuff if there's any on it. It's very dangerous. It can be fatal.
I don't think the fungus killed you.
All right, what did?
Parker did it!
Impossible.
Why?
It looks like every bone in that boy's body's broken. There's not a mark on him. We figure he hit that wall with incredible force.
Well, Jack Parker's pretty strong.
Nobody's that strong. I know you, Rossmore. And this isn't the first time you tried to cover something up because you don't want to smell bad in the press.
I beg your pardon, Lieutenant. You're addressing the president of an accredited university.
Don't interfere with this investigation. Don't withhold information. And don't play detective.
What about the mummy?
Well, you look for your mummy, Doctor. I'm looking for a murderer.
Susie and I have been researching a theory of sorts. First of all, I want to warn you, it's going to sound very unbelievable, but please just bear with me. I know it can't be proved, but this fungus, well, I think we all agree it's like nothing else we've ever encountered.
I'd have to agree with that.
Suppose that was because it didn't come from Earth.
Where else would it have come from?
I can't. You've seen this x-rays of our mummy. You said he wasn't a normal human being. Suppose he wasn't a human being.
Doug.
I said it would sound crazy. Remember the scroll? It said all who touched the weary traveler became afflicted and died, except Ankh Vinharis, because he was immune. Because he wasn't human.
We all agree that we're dealing with something unknown. But I can't, myself, take a quantum leap into the supernatural. I'm sorry, Professor, but with all due respect, we have to have some basis in fact.
I've got the best available equipment at my disposal. I've come up with absolutely nothing. I mean, it simply does not exist.
Look, Doug, the bottom line is this. Whatever it is, we still have to find out who took it and where it is now. Otherwise, more people are going to get hurt.
Thanks to McCadden, we are in deep trouble. Two of our donors have withdrawn their bequests. $500,000 out the window. Oh.
Maybe there's a way of turning this whole thing around.
How, Bruce? How?
What if he stole the mummy?
Huh?
He wasn't ready to unveil that mummy, so he had it stolen and hidden where he could work on it in private. And then when he's ready to find it and unveil it, he'll find it and come out a big hero.
No, I don't think that scenario is going to hold water, Bruce.
I do, and I think I can prove it.
You don't think it's walking around on its own, do you?
Doug, look.
Where's that coming from?
My bracelet.
Suze, that looks exactly like the diagram that I found inside the scroll.
It can't be a coincidence.
Susie, where'd you get this bracelet?
Well, it was a
present from this guy named Stanley.
You know where he came from?
No.
Susie, can you call him?
Now?
Yeah, honey, it's important. That diagram and this crystal have the same pattern. They've got to be related.
I've seen that pattern before. I know I have, or something like it anyway. When you asked me about it in your office, I couldn't remember, but...
What, hon? What?
I know. My brother used to build radios, and I think he had diagrams lying around that looked like that.
Radios? Radios. You know, maybe Parker will know.
This was in the coffin?
Yeah.
It's amazing. It looks like some kind of wiring schematic.
Like for making radios?
Right, but what would it be doing in a 3,000-year-old coffin?
Jack, could this have something to do with it?
Maybe. Crystals could be used as transmitters.
Jack, look at this.
What's going on, Doug? There must be a connection.
If this did belong to Ankh van Haris, what would he have used it for? I mean, he couldn't have been building radios in ancient Egypt.
Susie, I want you to go to the Astronomy Center, see what else you can find on ancient phenomena. But also, check out those NASA information bulletins on ultra-long-range communication. Honey, if you don't find anything, come right back.
Okay. What's it printed on? This doesn't feel like paper.
Analysis came up a blank. Matches no other material, either natural or synthetic.
Like nothing else, huh? Just like the fungus.
And Ankh van Haris.
Field trip. They all went to the observatory to see some comet or something.
Thank you.
Definitely a connection between the two. It's logical, but I still don't know what it means. Let me have another look at that crystal.
Susie.
Thank you.
Next thing I remember is waking up here.
Okay. I appreciate your answering these questions, Miss Fuller. If you think of anything else, give me a call, okay?
Lieutenant Plummer, you don't really still believe this is a fraternity joke, do you?
No. No, I think this is a very sick individual.
But, Lieutenant, it's...
Try to get some sleep now, okay?
Hysterical type, but it was him. It was Ankh Van Horus. He's alive. He didn't want to hurt me. He just wanted my bracelet. My crystal bracelet. It was glowing. And he had a crystal just like it in his chest.
Wasn't Ellen Waring's jewelry some kind of necklace?
Yeah, so was Bill Vogel, according to the coroner.
Susie, do you know if there's any more of those crystals?
No, I don't.
I'm going back to my office and check out that schematic again.
Go ahead, it's okay.
it, Doug?
You got it.
He was here.
What's that?
How did these get here?
One, two, three, four, five. Crystals?
Sharp.
Hey!
Where'd you get those crystals?
What crystals?
The ones you've been selling your friends.
I got them at the swap meet.
Sharp, don't lie to me.
What about these?
Ellen Winters and Bill Vogel are dead because of those crystals.
And Susie Fuller's in the hospital.
Anyone to get hurt. All right, where are the rest of them? There's one in my top drawer there. I gave the other one to my girlfriend.
Sherry?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, she's Jenny's roommate.
All right, call your girlfriend right now. She's at work.
Call her.
He is building a long-range communication device. He's got the circuitry. He's got the electrical transformer. He's got most of the crystals. What else does he need?
A power source.
Did you find her?
Yes, but she doesn't have it on. It's at home, bathroom cabinet. Jenny!
Love to Dad. I love you too. Bye.
Thank you.
This is Professor McCadden. Get your camera and come over to the reactor building. Linda, now.
Jenny! Jenny!
Jenny.
Did he touch you?
No. He took the crystal.
Thank you, Douglas.
What are you guys doing here?
Proving my theory. I knew all along that you'd taken that money, and now I know where you've hidden it.
What?
Oh, come off it, Professor.
Don't you realize what has been going on here?
Yes, as a matter of fact, you've been getting away with murder. Well, the game is over. And as soon as I call Lieutenant Plummer, you'll be on your way to jail, and I'll have what I deserve.
Jack!
Thank you.
The crystal! No!
If you're a film producer, and who isn't these days, the highest honor you can receive from our academy is this, the Irving Thalberg Award. Another young, hands-on producer has changed the look and the sound of not only his movies, but everybody else's movies. The awesome list of audience-pleasing entertainment for which he is responsible earns the Irving G. Thalberg Memorial Award for my valued colleague and great and loyal friend, George Lucas.
Thank the Academy members and the Board of Governors for this tremendous honor. After 20 years, this award comes at what I hope is the halfway point in my career, and I assure you that I will strive to be worthy of all it signifies. Thank you very, very much.
Wings.